Not understanding native speakers is a huge pain in the They connect words, they delete sounds, they change sounds, they have very thick accent, especially people from certain groups and ethnicities. There's basically a huge difference between the English that you read and the English that you hear, right? And this can cause a lot of frustration because we might think we know English and then we go out and we try to understand native speakers and we don't understand anything. Sounds familiar? Now, there exists one little secret, one little thing that you can do that will help you understand them all. If you apply this one little secret that I'm going to teach you in this video, it will help you understand TV shows without subtitles, understand when people speak fast, understand when people mumble a lot. And if you apply it yourself in your own speaking, it will help you sound a lot more natural and native-like. And the best thing of them all, if you know this secret and you apply it, you will never have to take another boring English class in your life. Are you ready? Let's get started. Now, before I reveal this secret to you, feel free to activate subtitles here below to help you understand better. Feel free to change the speed. If you think I'm talking too fast, slow me down. If you think I'm talking too slowly, speed me up. Also, please make sure to like this video. Click on that little like button there. Just that simple click really helps the video to reach more people who need to learn English, who need to improve their English so that they can improve their lives and the lives of their families. So, what is the secret that will help you understand native speakers? The secret is reductions. In this video, I will teach you the most common reductions, and you will even practice to speak with them so that you can understand all of the English that you hear from native speakers, whether that may be in real life or when watching native speakers speak online or in movies. Let's start with greetings, how we say hello to someone. These are very common phrases that a lot of students don't understand even though they've read them 100 times. What's up? What's up is typically reduced to just sup, 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 sup. We basically reduce the entire phrase down to just zup. How is it going? How is it going? A very typical phrase to ask someone how they are. How are you? How is it going? But everyone says, how's it going? How's it going? Do you see that G there at the end of the phrase? It is completely silent. And we just reduce down the word to make it sound smoother and faster. How's it going? How are you going? How are you going? How are you going is also a very typical phrase to ask someone how they are doing, how they are. Typically in Australia, they say this a lot. But we do not say, how are you going? We say, how you going? How you going? You see that the G there at the end of the phrase is also reduced. How are you? How are you? The most common phrase, or one of the most common phrases in English. We don't say, how are you? We say, how are you? How are you? We reduce the phrase down to this quick sounds. How are you? Say that with me. How are you? I'm good, thanks. Good. Next step. Reductions with you. Whenever there's a you in a phrase in English, native speakers typically reduce them down as well. So the phrase, what do you, is reduced to what are ya. So we say, what do you like for dinner? What do you do for work? Or it can also be reduced to whatcha, whatcha. What you like for dinner? What you do for work? Instead of what do you. What are you? What are you doing tomorrow? What are you up to today, for example? What are you is also reduced to what are ya or whatcha, just as what do you. So we say, what are you doing tomorrow? What are you up to today? Or what you doing tomorrow? Or what you up to today? So we reduce what are you down to what are ya or whatcha as well. Where do you? Where do you want to go for dinner? This gets reduced down to where ya. Or wedja, wedja. So, where do you want to go for dinner? Or where do you want to go for dinner? Where do you want to go for dinner? Or where do you want to go for dinner? Now, one extra thing here, want to gets reduced to wanna, wanna. You see, there's not even a T in there, wanna. So we say, what do you wanna go for dinner? Or where'd you wanna go for dinner? Do you like pizza? Gets reduced to do ya, or ja. So we say, do you like pizza? Do you like pizza? Do you like pizza? I love pizza. Could you do me a favor? We say, could ya? Could you do me a favor? Would you like to go on a date with me? Would you gets reduced down to would ya? Would ya? Would you like to go out tonight? Wouldn't you gets reduced down to wouldn't ya? Wouldn't ya? So we say, this is quite fun, wouldn't you say? Now, we have reductions with the word have. Also, super common for native speakers, whenever there's a have in a phrase, they reduce the phrase down. Should have, super, super common in the English language to use this structure. Should have becomes should have, or shoulda, shoulda. For example, I shoulda known better. I shoulda known better. Would have, the same thing happens. Would have or woulda. For example, I would have started learning with Kallis sooner, I just didn't know about him. Could have is exactly the same. Could have or coulda. For example, if I had known about him, I could have gotten fluent sooner. Or I coulda gotten fluent sooner. Important note here, I know that this sounds very similar to could of, could of, could of, coulda, but it is not. And you're going to notice a lot of native speakers actually write like this, and it's wrong. It is not could of, it is could have or coulda. Native speakers also make mistakes, so be aware of that. Now, speaking of, let's go through some reductions with the word of. Whenever there's an of in a phrase in English, native speakers typically reduce that phrase as well. Kind of becomes kinda. It's kinda cold today. Sort of becomes sorta. There's been some sort of problem. We have a lot of these actually, and they're all the same. Some of becomes summa. Give me some of that sexiness. Out of becomes outa. It's getting late. Let's get out of here. A lot of becomes a lotta. I got a lot of things on my mind. Now, reductions with to. Very common for native speakers to, whenever there's a to in a phrase, reduce it down. Going to becomes gonna. What are we gonna do about this situation? Got to becomes gotta. I gotta be honest with you. Want to becomes wanna. Do you wanna watch some Netflix? Some other common reductions. Give me becomes gimme. Give me some of that pizza, please. Let me becomes lemme. Let me know when you're free next week. Them becomes just M. Pokemon, gotta catch them all. Him, her becomes im or er. She's moved on, let her go. Because becomes just cuz. For example, she went home cuz she felt sick. Now you are aware of this. That is awesome. But that does not mean you have learned this. A lot of English teachers and a lot of students as well believe that if you study about something, if you learn about these reductions, you immediately have learned them for the rest of your life. And that is not the case. Now you're aware of them. What you need to do now is you need to start consuming English 1 hour every day without subtitles every single day for a couple of months. That's the only way you're going to internalize and actually get accustomed to these reductions. That's the only way you're actually going to learn them properly. Just being aware of them is not enough. That's not how language learning works. You need to expose yourself to these reductions every single day, over and over, in order for them to internalize in your long-term memory, which is a requirement to be able to produce them, speak them intuitively, automatically, without thinking about them. So please make sure you do that. From now on, you go out and you consume English without subtitles every day, and you're going to get accustomed to these reductions. But that's not it. In order to get 100% fluent, you also need to expand your vocabulary. There were a couple of words here that you didn't know, right? A couple of words in these phrases that made it hard for you to understand them, weren't there? Not just do you need to practice listening daily, you also need to expand your vocabulary to at least 3,000 words. When you know the 3,000 most common words in the English language, you have covered 98% of all the words that are used in daily conversations between native speakers. And the best way to learn these words fast is to consume them in phrases using the spaced repetition technique. If you do that, you will forget less, you'll remember a lot faster, your speaking will be a lot more intuitive, and also by consuming phrases, you're internalizing grammar structures, which is a necessity to be able to create long and beautiful sentences without thinking, without translating. That is exactly what Lena did. Lena is one of my students in my English course. I actually met her a couple of weeks ago, and she showed me this video. This is Lena 6 months ago when she first joined the program.
My friend's birthday, it's on the 6th. On February. He lives comfortably in a rural area outside the city, but often likes to come visit.
As you can see here, her level is quite basic. She's struggling with reading simple words, simple phrases, and also with her pronunciation. This was her 6 months ago, and this is her today, 6 months later.
In this moment, I know that I made thousands of mistakes when I speak. I know. But I couldn't care less.
Yes.
I think I got rid of my fears. I got rid of many things, and I can express myself, and I know that people can understand what I say. I think that people can talk to me and have a fluent conversation, and it's not a problem because I don't care if I've made a mistake or not. And it's thanks to this method, or this different method that that I tried, and I can see the result now.
Now, isn't that amazing? Wouldn't it be awesome if you had a similar transformation like her? Wouldn't it feel absolutely fantastic to finally be able to speak naturally, intuitively, without translating in your head all the time? This is exactly what happened to Lena when she followed the process in my English course. And it can happen to you too, if you take action. We currently have a super offer for you, 90% off my English course, but for a limited time. Click on the link here above or below here in the description to claim this offer before it's gone. Look at this image right here. This is your life. How much of your life have you already consumed? Would you want to live the rest of your limited life not being able to speak English fluently? Not having extra opportunities, not being integrated in the English-speaking society, in the global world. Click on the link here below, and I hope to see you inside my student community so we can get you fluent in the most effective way possible. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, give me a like, please, so this video can reach more people who need to learn English, and subscribe as well so you don't miss out on any future videos. Thank you so, so much. I'll see you in the next video.